There's been a new development in the disappearance of Sydney con woman Melissa Caddick. Police say parts of a human torso found at Mollymook on the state's south coast are not hers, but they have confirmed the remains of a foot in a sneaker, which were discovered further south, do belong to Melissa Caddick. The 49-year-old vanished in November after ASIC officials raided her home. Caddick is accused of swindling around $20 million from investors. Remains were also found at two other beaches on the weekend, and they are undergoing forensic testing. And criminal psychology expert Tim Watson-Munro joins me now. Tim, morning to you. New South Wales, it's hard to sort of follow this police investigation. Each day it seems to have something new, but New South Wales police have not ruled out murder. They say suicide is more likely. You believe Melissa Caddick was killed. Why do you think that?
I think suicide's possible, but the least likely option. She's dead. We don't want to defame her too much, but clearly a narcissist. Clearly somebody who has no remorse, psychopathic in terms of her manipulation of others and so on. And I think she would have had a plan B. So suicides are possible. I think it's more possible and probable that she ended her life at the hands of someone else. She was either killed by people who knew her, or somebody was standing over her to get the money and so on.
Right.
So it's more likely that she killed herself. Didn't kill herself, that she was murdered.
Okay, yes. Well, that was what I was going to ask you. If she has met with foul play, who could be responsible? Would it be most likely? I mean, the police must have a list as long as their arm. A victim of her scam or someone else?
I think it could be a victim of her scam. It could be somebody who just wanted the money, may have tortured her to get the money. Or somebody who's a co-accused. There's a lot of money that's unaccounted for, and it may be that she worked in concert with other people, and it would be the perfect crime to kill her, leave a foot on a beach. By the way, how many beaches and how many sand shoes would have her foot? You know, it just seems the probability of that is very, very remote. So it's quite possible that she was killed and other people have the money. It's that whole spectrum of possibilities, but I think the greatest probability is that she was killed at the hands of somebody else.
I have never in my life as a journalist seen police through the newspapers and through the media go into so much detail about, you know, where a body could end up on a beach and how far it would float and what happens to a body. I mean, it's awful to read. But do you think that she, the original theory that she jumped off the gap in Sydney is totally out of the question, and that this, if it's a murder, happened more recently than November?
I think it happened more recently than November. It's not my area of expertise, but experts that I've spoken to say you would expect much greater degradation of the shoe than the one that they've found. When she disappeared, it's peak time in Sydney. There's people out on boats. People commit suicide at the Gap, sadly, too often. I've spoken to people from Bondi Rescue over the years, and they're constantly finding people out at sea. She wasn't found. So although it's not totally impossible that she would have floated all that way over 3 months, I think it's highly improbable and more likely that she was killed closer to where the shoe was found more recently.
It's just all so strange, isn't it? Tim, it's great to chat to you. Thank you for your insight. We appreciate it.
Always a pleasure, Sam. Thanks very much.
Tim Watson-Munro there.